The advanced tab has some information that's primarily used internally. When the last hold was released, when the order was completed, the printer status, the last invoice entered on, when it was last printed, the basis exchange rate. This defaults when you save the order, and it's the exchange rate today if it's a foreign currency order, and that's used with the currency surcharge or discount based on currency fluctuations. The hold history, whenever an order or a line gets placed on hold, it records it in the hold history so that even if it's cleared, you still have the history of what the holds were and the number, the ship to ID, the status of the order, what work cell it's in, what the status of the work cell is, and a revision number. The attributes for an order are similar to the attributes from the customer, but these are attributes that are specific to the order. So here we have, here's an attribute, do not use bill to address for this order. We talked about in the customer record that you can have a separate bill to address and a company address, where normally the invoices are sent to the bill to address. Well, this is an attribute that can be set so that for this particular invoice, it gets sent to the company address, not to the bill to address. So the attributes will sometimes be really exotic features. We've got some test information here. So here are attributes that we can have additional things that we want to add to an order that we don't have fields for. Over here, we have actions. Actions can be added to sales orders. And then we've got some EDI information, when the order acknowledgement was sent, the different order acknowledgement types, and what revision it is. So that's all related to our order header. Now we get to the lines. We can either enter an item number directly if we know it, and it defaults. And now here's an example where we had order entry attributes set by line. And if you remember, there's a field in the catalog that had order entry attributes set. And if we put this set in it, then this causes it to pop up and say, okay, what color do you want this to be? We'll say green. And then it asks us the next option, what faceplate color, what port number we want it on, what position we want it. There's no table set up for this. We want it in the third bay, and what type. So here we've captured additional information about this sales order line. In this particular case, this would be for a company that assembles computers, and the computer is going to have a CD-ROM in it, and this has information about how that should be configured. We have a quantity, the price defaults. This price is called the target price. The target price comes out of the special pricing system. It looks at all the prices available for this customer and this item based upon the quantity and comes up with the lowest price available to the customer. Now, this tells us that this catalog record is not fully formed. It says there's a unit of measure code missing, which tells us that that we can't save this item until the item gets edited. So we'll pick a different item here. Let's pick this one. We can manually enter the price, and now we've added it to the order. Now this tells us that this order is placed on hold because this item had the auto hold flag checked. And this has popped up now, the related items saying, oh, if you sell one of these, try to peddle one of these to the customer too. So we tell it, we've added that item. Okay. So now we've added these two items to the order. We can go back here and enter a price for this one. And we can, here we have a broker item. This is a special order item that's not in the catalog that allows us to use a generic item and to then either add the description in the description field or to add it as a comment when we want to sell something that's not in our catalog.